This video is probably going to gross out a lot of you. I have always had this kind of morbid curiosity about what is that gunk inside my mouthpiece if I haven't cleaned it in a day or two or three or maybe a week or maybe longer. What is the crud that's on my reeds that I might not even be able to see after I've stored them in a pouch for a couple of days or a week or maybe longer? What I have done is I have assembled some, basically this is going to be my science project for the day. I borrowed from a friend of mine, Mitch Fadem, who is a microbiologist living in Las Vegas. He lent me his professional luminometer, which I'll explain what that is in a minute. And I want to test some of these reeds, that mouthpiece, and a few other things to find out, like, what is on it. But for those of you who get queasy when you see mold on some cheese in your refrigerator, this is just a word of warning. This may gross you out, but I think it's going to be fascinating and I'm going to have a lot of fun doing it. So let's get started. So before we get started, I want to talk about the stuff I'm going to be using to run these experiments. First off is this thing. It's a petri dish. I'm sure most of you recognize it. And there is this layer of agar on the bottom, which is stuff that bacteria and fungi love to eat. So if you're going to do, like, I don't know, a science project at home, you would take a sterile swab and you would swab your toilet, say, or whatever, and then you'd run that swab over the agar on this thing and you'd let it sit for 4 days or so. This device is called a luminometer, and a luminometer is a more instant device to measure what ATP levels are on any particular sample. Now, ATP is a chemical marker, an enzyme that's found in anything that's living. It's plants, animals, bacteria, and how it's often used is in restaurants. So let's say in the kitchen of a restaurant, somebody cleans the surface of a counter, say, then they'll run this swab over the counter to collect whatever is on that counter to see, and they'll stick it in this device here, and it will come up with a number, which is measured in RLU, relative light units. And so if there's a high number, that means that there is a lot of contamination on that surface. If it's a low number or zero, that means it's sterile. So what we're going to do first is I'm going to swab the inside of my mouth to see what kind of stuff is in there and if there's a lot of it. Now, just to give you a benchmark, raw meat is not allowed to be sold if it's over 2,000 RLU. Okay, so 2,000 RLU is safe meat to eat. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to pull the swab out. I'm going to swab the inside of my mouth. Now I'm going to stick it back inside this, break the seal for the stuff that's on the top, and I'm going to swirl it around inside. Now I'm going to take it, I'm going to stick it inside the luminometer, and I'm going to close it, and I'm going to hit OK. Now it has to measure it for 15 seconds, and remember, anything above 2,000 is gross. It means that there's a lot of ATP and sort of maybe bacterial energy going on. Let's see. Oh dear God. Okay, so my mouth would not be allowed to be sold as ground beef. Ew. I'm sorry, Catherine. No kissing. All right, so let's test a few other things. This is gonna be fun. Okay, so like any good scientist, I have on a pair of sterile gloves. Not that this is an actual science experiment, but I had them around. And I have here as my baseline a brand new unopened Van Doren reed. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open it, and I'm going to run a swab over it to see what our baseline is. So with the swab with some sterile water, and I'm going to swab it front and back. Great. So then put it in here, break the seal, jiggle it like it's supposed to, and I'm going to put it in the luminometer. And it is an RLU of 4. That means it is basically as clean as it can be. The lowest obviously is a 0, this is a 4. So we now know that a brand new reed is essentially sterile. What I've got here is a bag of disgusting reeds. What I did was I took some old reeds and I dampened them a bit, and then I stuck them in this bag for about 4 months to see what would grow. And what's happened is you can actually see some black funk down here. I don't know what it is, but it's not healthy looking. And on the reeds themselves, you might even be able to see, we'll get a closer look in a second, some fuzz that's growing on them. So these, I think, would classify as reeds that I would never put in my mouth. Let me take one of these disgusting reeds from my pouch. It's got all sorts of funk on it. Oh my God, how disgusting. Brand new swab. I'm gonna swab the front of this thing, getting all of the moldy goodness onto it. I'll swab the back. Put it in here. Ha! 4025. Big X. See ya! And then, just for the sake of it, let's take a reed that I have here that has not gone through the whole mold thing. Now, this is a reed that I would actually put in my mouth, and have, and I'm going to test this one. Oh, so it's just 103. Look, I feel much, 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 much better now knowing that that isn't as disgusting as it could be. Okay, so now that we know that these reeds are totally disgusting, what are we going to do to try to clean them? Okay, so the first thing I have here available to me is this bottle of hydrogen peroxide, which costs maybe a couple dollars at a drugstore. Hydrogen peroxide, as all of you probably know, is what they use to treat small wounds. If you cut yourself, you pour some hydrogen peroxide on it, it foams up, and it's supposed to sanitize the wound. You can also use it as mouthwash. In fact, it's in a lot of toothpaste you can buy. And so it is safe to be inside your mouth. I wouldn't drink it, but it is something that can be inside your mouth, and I've been soaking this reed in it now for about 25 minutes or half an hour. I've done this in the past to reeds that are less questionable than this, but I'm just really curious to see if something like this would work with a reed that is this gross. Now, the second thing I have, as I mentioned, is the Silverstein reed cure, and the way the reed cure works is you slide a couple reeds inside it, right here, whoop, there it goes, a couple reeds inside it right here. When you close the lid, ultraviolet light turns on, ozone voodoo happens inside the whole thing, and in 5 minutes, it's supposed to sanitize your reeds. This thing, I think, retails for maybe about $100 in stores. Let's start with this hydrogen peroxide. So what I have here is a sterile sponge, and I'm going to use that sponge to dry off my reed. Bada bing! Look at that. So that's something that I would clearly put in my mouth. If the reed that I use every day is, 103? This 65 is actually cleaner than that. That's pretty darn impressive for a $2 bottle of hydrogen peroxide. Let's take a look at the Silverstein Reed Cure reeds. Ooh. Oh, not a good sign. Not a good sign at all. Well, let's try the other one. Yeah. Yeah, that's not a good sign. That's not a good sign. Well, I'm really, really sorry about this. But apparently this does not clean that disgusting of a reed, not to the point where I would put it in my mouth. So in this particular case, I'm sorry to say that the hydrogen peroxide is the winner. Now, as long as we're testing things that go in our mouth, let me test my mouthpiece. So. All right, buddy, it's time for you to get cleaned out. That just goes to show you that it's possible that the things that are on these reeds and on this mouthpiece isn't super dangerous, because I play on this mouthpiece all the time and I have not gotten sick from it, but it's so clear that it needs to get washed. All right, so I got my disgusting mouthpiece and I'm taking some hydrogen peroxide and I'm just soaking this very, very, very soft microfiber cloth with it. And I'm gonna go in here and I'm going to gently rub the mouthpiece inside and out with it. Ideally, I should probably soak it, but I hope that for the sake of my sanity and my health, this will take care of it. Yeah, now we're getting there. 116. Keeping your mouthpiece clean is a good idea. Here we are in one of my favorite rooms of the house, and we're going to give this one a little sample. What? So, ladies and gentlemen, this just goes to show you that your toilet is cleaner than your reeds, even when you've cleaned them. So there you have it. Our mouthpieces and reeds can get really, really gross really quickly. But the fortunate thing is, this $2 bottle of hydrogen peroxide will take care of that problem for you. What you need to do with your reeds, right now if you want, is go and pour yourself a nice tall glass of hydrogen peroxide, take all your reeds and dump them in there, and let them foam, and you'll see them, they'll just start foaming up, because that is all the bacteria being sterilized, clean, sanitized by the hydrogen peroxide. You let that foam die down, you pour that water, you pour the hydrogen peroxide out, you fill it up with clean water, and you let them soak a little bit more. You rinse them off, you pour that out, and you let them soak even a little bit longer. The hydrogen peroxide is safe for you to have in your mouth, but it does have a little bit of a taste. Why do you need to keep your reeds clean, other than the fact that that's just kind of gross? Let me tell you a quick story. A guy that I used to play in an orchestra with, who I will not name, used to play on reeds that I would have considered questionable. They had little black specks on them. I wasn't sure if that was maybe from his sandpaper that he used or what. It wasn't any of my business. But then one day he let everybody know that he had to go into the hospital for heart surgery. I am not making this up. Heart surgery. Because he had gotten a splinter in his tongue from his reed, and some of the bacteria must have gotten into his bloodstream, made its way to his heart, and started disintegrating his heart valves. You can't make this stuff up. So be safe. Clean your reeds, clean your mouthpieces, just play on clean equipment, okay? Who knew that this was such a dirty and dangerous career that we've all chosen? I didn't. Anyway, be safe. See you next time.